In this video, we're going to be going over some of the basics for the full inverse airfoil design in Xfoil. This is where we take a velocity distribution profile and turn it into an airfoil shape. Let's get to it. Up until now, we've been doing a design method, or what I prefer to call analysis approach, to Xfoil. What this means is that we started with an airfoil shape, we then turned that shape into an airfoil coordinate file, we then took that airfoil coordinate file and loaded it into Xfoil, and then we would take that airfoil in Xfoil and look at the performance it would have under certain flow conditions, right? We might specify the Reynolds number or the Mach number to specify the flow conditions around that airfoil, and then we look at the performance. Up until now, all the videos that we have done has focused on a piece of this method. Now, I will say there are plenty more videos that I can do on this topic, specifically that big arrow that I labeled design method. I really don't like calling it design method. I like calling it analysis method because we already start with an airfoil design. But if you're looking in any documentation, this is usually called the design method. In this video, we're going to talk about what's called the full inverse design method, right? It's called inverse because we're going the other way. We are starting with the desired performance in terms of a velocity distribution around the airfoil, and we're going from that to an airfoil shape. And then once we have this airfoil shape, we can go ahead and do whatever we need to do with that, whether that's just exporting the coordinate files so that we can, you know, put it into our CAD software, or looking at the pressure distribution for different angles of attack, or if we want to look at the polar plots for our new airfoil shape. So this video, we're going to just look at some of the basics when trying to do a full inverse design method in Xfoil. So let's go ahead and talk about this velocity distribution plot that Xfoil generates for us to use as we're doing the full inverse design method. The x-axis is the chord location corresponding to the surface velocity that's plotted on the y. This is why it's called a distribution plot, because we're looking at how the surface velocity changes based on where you're at on the surface of the airfoil. Now, Xfoil does something a little bit different than your typical velocity distribution plot. It actually separates the lower surface from the upper surface, as well as flipping the sign on the lower surface so that it has a negative value. Now, a velocity distribution plot is similar to a pressure distribution plot. We've talked about that in the past, how the pressure distribution plot just shows us how the pressure changes around the surface of the airfoil. So depending where you're located on the airfoil, you're going to have a different pressure. If you think of Bernoulli's equation, the higher the velocity, the lower the pressure, the lower the velocity, the higher the pressure. So there's going to be a relationship between the pressure distribution plot and the velocity distribution plot. Now, similar to how Xfoil loads an airfoil, this plot starts at the trailing edge, loops around the lower surface to the leading edge, and then goes from the leading edge, wraps around the upper surface, and returns back to the trailing edge. Now, let's go ahead and talk about the y-axis of the velocity distribution plot. The y-axis is the airflow speed on the surface in relation to the free stream velocity. This means that if you have a value of 1 on the y-axis, then the surface speed equals the free stream velocity. Now, it's not quite the same as some of the other velocity distribution plots, This is because Xfoil first splits it into lower surface and upper surface, and then it flips the sign on the lower surface so that it's negative, which essentially mirrors the plot around the zero Y location. And then it does something else where it starts at the trailing edge, wraps around the lower surface, goes to the leading edge, wraps around the upper surface, goes back to the trailing edge. And so what this does is it essentially mirrors a plot again across the leading edge. So if you're wanting to turn this plot into what a normal velocity plot looks like, you have to take that bottom left plot, mirror it across to the right, and then mirror that up to the top plot. And that's what your normal velocity distribution looks like. There is a command in the MDES menu that allows you to reflect the upper surface to the lower surface and the lower surface to the upper surface. I did it here on this plot. It's kind of hard to see, but it's the faint lines there. It's a little bit weird, but once you kind of understand what's going on with the plot, it's not that hard to get used to. All right, let's go ahead and start looking at some of the basic steps that you follow when doing the full inverse design. The first step is to load an airfoil into Xfoil. And I have another video on this, so if you're not familiar or if you're having problems doing this, go ahead and check that other video out. Xfoil is not a pure inverse design method. What this means is that it follows the iterative method, which is more realistic in terms of how airfoils are designed. And so this airfoil that we're loading is essentially the starting place that we're going to use to create our new airfoil. Now, if you try to drop down into the MDES menu from the main menu without loading an airfoil, you will get an error that says no airfoil available and it won't let you drop down into it. However, if you do have a surface speed distribution that you want to start out with, that's perfectly fine. However, you're still gonna need to enter an airfoil in to be able to drop down into the menu. So go ahead and choose what airfoil you wanna start with for this method. So your next step is going to be to drop down from the main menu into the MDES menu. MDES is the complex mapping design routine menu. And you do this just by typing MDES into the command prompt. And when you do that, you should see a window open up with the plot you see here in the bottom right. That's our velocity distribution plot. And you should see some additional text underneath the command that you entered, just giving you some further information. Now we actually need to talk about some of that further information, specifically the last two lines, because those last two lines are cluing you into the fact that when you drop down from the main menu into the MDES menu, Xfoil is actually automatically running a few commands for you if you don't already have the velocity distribution specification from a previous analysis of an airfoil. So if you don't already have the surface speed distribution, it's going to go ahead and run through a few commands, and we'll talk about that on the next slide. First things first, when you load an airfoil into Xfoil, whether you use the knocker command or the load command, is going to first place that airfoil into the buffer airfoil memory, and then it's going to run either PCOP or PANE, P-A-N-E, and transfer this buffer airfoil into the current airfoil memory location. Right, that's typical of using the knocker command or the load command. When you drop down into the MDES menu without an already specified velocity distribution, here on the chart it's called Q. If you don't already have that, it's going to take the current airfoil, run it at the last alpha that has been performed during this session of Xfoil. If this is a new session, it's going to run it at an angle of attack of 0. And it's going to take the results it gets and create its own velocity distribution named Q. That's why we're getting the line current Q operating condition alpha equals 0, CL equals 0.5092. Now the next step that it does is that it takes that current airfoil velocity distribution and it puts it into this QSpec memory. QSpec is the desired velocity distribution of the airfoil we want to create. So this line that you see that says QSpec initialized to current Q, it's just taking the velocity distribution that it created when it ran the airfoil at the last known angle of attack, and it's using that as a starting location, right? The starting specification for the desired velocity distribution. And that is actually also where this plot is coming from. So now you have the starting point for your desired velocity distribution. The MDEs menu is full of commands that you can use to modify this desired velocity distribution to meet your needs. For a list of the commands, if you type in a question mark and hit enter, it'll spit out a list of all the commands available to you in the MDEs menu that you can use to modify this desired surface speed distribution. A quick note, if you're dealing with a symmetric airfoil, I would go ahead and turn on the symmetric airfoil flag to make sure that you force it to be symmetric. If it's not a symmetric airfoil, do not turn on the flag. And of course, I will create additional videos in the future covering these different commands that are available to you to modify this QSpec. So go ahead and pause the video if you need to and take some time to modify the velocity distribution about the airfoil to suit your needs. Alright, so now we have the velocity distribution that we want our new airfoil shape to have. So the next step is to convert this velocity distribution into an airfoil shape. And the command that is there to do that in the MDEs menu is the exec command. That's EXEC. When you do that, Xfoil will run through its full inverse design routine to convert this desired velocity distribution into a new airfoil shape. It will spit out some information to you underneath the command prompt. And again, those last two lines contain some valuable information for at least this video on the topic. It says that a new buffer airfoil is generated, and then the last line says execute pane, that's P-A-N-E, at the top level to set new current airfoil. This is important because a lot of people forget this step or forget that Xfoil does this. When you run the exec command, it does not put the new airfoil into the current airfoil memory. It only puts it in the buffer. It's trying to make sure you don't overwrite something that you might not have saved yet. So the next step would be to go up a level from the MDEs menu to the main menu. And you do this by hitting enter at the MDEs command prompt. After you've done this, the next step would be to move the new airfoil from the buffer airfoil memory to the current airfoil memory. And you do this at the top level by using the pane command. That's P-A-N-E. After you've done that, you have the new airfoil shape in the current airfoil memory. From here, step 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, whatever you need to do from here, you're able to go ahead and do on the current airfoil. Whether that's save off the airfoil coordinates, whether that's maybe look at the pressure distribution plots for some of the other off-design angle of attacks, whether you want to look at some of the polar plots. Basically, now you have the new airfoil shape in the current airfoil memory, and you're able to do whatever you need to do to that shape. I think that covers it for the basic steps of the full inverse design. If you have any questions or any problems, go ahead and leave a comment below and I'll try and help you through any problems you might have. And of course, like the video, subscribe to the channel. Let me know if there's a particular topic you want to see on Xfoil. And in the meantime, go ahead and click on that next video where we're going to continue to learn Xfoil. I'll see you there.